Hi friends, I am Sunil, working as BSNL JEE. Welcome to BSNL JEE 2016 exam preparation. In this video, I am going to discuss electrical specialization remaining topics. AC machines. In AC machines, transformers. Transformer is a static device. That means it has no rotating parts. So transformer is a static device which transfers electrical power from one voltage to another voltage without changing the frequency. That means it transfers the power from one voltage to another voltage, and frequency as constant. And coming to the working principle of this transformer, it works on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. And particularly we can say a mutual inductance principle. That means when the two coils are coupled, when the current flows through the coil one, and the flux will be produced, and this flux will be links with the coil two, and then an EMF will be induced in coil two, principle is called mutual induction principle. That means an EMF will be induced in secondary coil due to the flux of the first coil is called mutual induction principle. Okay. And transformer is a constant frequency device, and it is because transformer is a constant frequency device, and in this transformation power is also constant. Only voltage and currents are varying. And transformer is a coupled device, electrically isolated and magnetically coupled. That means here it is the core, it is one winding, it is another winding. These two windings are electrically isolated. That means no direct contact between these windings. Okay, these are coupled with magnetic circuit. And it is a singly excited device. That means it is excited only single source. Okay, but in case of synchronous motor is doubly excited machine. Very, very important. Synchronous motor is a doubly excited machine, and transformer is a singly excited machine. Here doubly excited means the field winding is excited with the DC source, and AC source is given to the supply, given as supply. Okay, and the rating of transformer is in KVA, kilovolt amperes. Okay, rating of transformer is in KVA. And coming to the characteristics of ideal transformers. For the characteristics of ideal transformers, winding resistance must be zero for ideal transformers. And magnetic leakage flux is zero. That means perfect coupling. The coupling will must be perfect coupling. That is K equal to 1. K equal to 1 means perfect coupling. And next one, permeability of the transformer core is infinite. And that means high permeability. That means permeability of the transformer core is infinite. Infinite means very high. Iron losses are assumed to be zero. Iron losses are nothing but hysteresis losses plus eddy current losses. So both hysteresis and eddy current losses are assumed to be zero. And magnetic curve of transformer is linear. These are characteristics of ideal transformers. And coming to that, this is a simple diagram of a transformer. Here, this is the core of the transformer. It is the core of the transformer. These are windings. It is one winding. It is another winding. This is the number of turns is denoted by, for first winding is N1. For this winding is N2. Here, which is a primary, which is secondary means the winding which is connected to the supply is called primary winding. The winding which is connected to the supply is called primary winding. And the winding which is connected to the load side is called secondary winding. Secondary winding. These are primary turns. These are secondary turns. These are called windings. And according to the Faraday law, what is Faraday law? Whenever flux links the coil changes, whenever flux links this coil changes, an EMF will be induced. An EMF will be induced. That EMF E equal to minus N d pi by dt. Minus N d pi by dt. This is minus is due to Lenz's law. Minus is due to Lenz's law. What is the Lenz's law? The effect. Effect is nothing but produced EMF. That means induced EMF. The effect opposes the cause. Opposes the cause. Cause means change in flux. That means the produced or induced EMF opposes the change in the flux. So that's why the negative symbol denotes. That means it opposes, means the here we have given negative sign. Okay. And coming to the parts of the transformer. Coming to the parts of the transformer, main part of the transformer is core and windings. Core and winding. Coming to the core, the material used for this core is it is made up of silicon steel or CRGO steels. Silicon steel or CRGO steel. CRGO means cold rolled grain orient steel. Cold rolled grain orient steel. For a small machine or small and medium type of transformers, silicon steel is used. For very high capacity transformers, CRGO steel is used. Okay. And the requirement of the core or requirement of the core, the core must be high permeability. The core must be high permeability and it has low hysteresis losses and core is laminated to reduce the eddy current losses. Okay. And windings. Coming to the windings, these are windings. This is a primary winding. It is a secondary winding. Okay, these windings. Copper is used as a winding material. And coming to the other parts. Of the transformer, bushings. Bushings means nothing but insulators. These are the function of these bushings to bring the terminal inside to outside. To bring the terminals inside to outside. That means to bring the terminals inside to outside. We can, these are called as bushings. We can see these bushings outside of the transformer, top of the transformer. This is for faces, R face, Y face, B face, and some neutral face, That means the terminals, the faces are terminals of the transformer. From inside to outside, these bushings are employed. That means these bushings are nothing but insulators to bring the terminals inside to outside. Okay. Next, coming to the breather. The purpose of this breather is nothing but it is the purpose of breather is extracting the moisture. And next, coming to the conservator. Conservator is a small tank. The main function of this conservator is to take up contractions and expansions of oil. Okay. Next, coming to the types of transformers. Based on construction, there are mainly two types, core type and shell type. first of all core type and shell type. And in case of core type, the core is surrounded, the core is surrounded by windings, the core is surrounded by windings. In case of shell type, windings, these windings are surrounded by core, these windings are surrounded by core. This means here core is surrounded by windings means there is no protection of windings. That means no mechanical protection for windings. Here good mechanical protections for windings. And here the leakage flux is more. Here there is no leakage flux. That means the leakage flux is very very less. And it is a series magnetism. That means the flux. It is a series magnetism. That means the flux produced in this coil is flows through this circuit. In this case, the flux is divides into two parts. That is here pi by 2, here pi by 2. So it is a parallel magnetism. And amount of copper required in this core type is very high. Amount of copper required is very high. And here very low. Okay. And insulating material required is less. In case of core type, insulating material is less. In case of shell type, insulating material is high. And the voltage capacity mainly depends on this insulating material. The voltage capacity mainly depends on this insulating material. Here insulating material required is less. So it is used for high voltage purpose. So that means core type transformers are used for high voltage and small kVA ratings. High voltage and small kVA ratings. Very very important. Very very important. Why this core type transformer used for high voltage and small kVA ratings? Because the insulating material for this core type is very very less. So the voltage capacity is mainly depend upon insulating material. So that's why this core type transformers are used for high voltage and smaller kVA ratings. In this here insulating material is very high, required is very high. That means the shell type transformers used for low voltage and large kVA rating. Low voltage and large kVA rating. And next one, step up transformers and step down transformers. Very 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 important. Step up and step down transformers. Step up transformers means it step ups the voltage. The step up transformer step ups the voltage. That means the output voltage is greater than the input voltage. In case of step down transformer, it step downs the voltage. That means input voltage is greater than the output voltage. It step downs the voltage. Okay. And here the primary number of, here in case of step up transformer, the primary turns are very less. The primary turns are N1 is less than that of N2. N1 is less than that of N2. Here in case of step down transformer, primary turns are greater than N2. Primary turns are greater than N2. That means here as number of turns increases, we know that EMF E equal to N d pi by dt minus N d pi by dt. As number of turns increases means the EMF will be increases. EMF will be increases means the terminal voltage is very high. In this way, step up transformer step ups the voltage. Here in case the primary turns are very high and secondary turns are very low, as number of turns decreases and EMF will be decreases. That means here the terminal voltage, output voltage or terminal voltage in secondary reduces. That means it step downs the voltage. In step up voltage, secondary voltage is very high. That means terminal voltage is very high and current is reverse. Current is reverse. As voltage here in transformers, the total power is constant. Total power is constant. As voltage increases means current will be must be decreases to decreases for maintaining constant power. That means here in step up transformer, secondary current will be less than that of primary current. Very very important. In step up transformer, secondary current is less than that of primary current. And K is a transformation ratio, and that is N2 by N1. That means k equal to, k is always greater than 1 for step up transformers, because n2 is very high, n2 by n1 and n2 is very high. So that means k is always greater than 1, and here k is always less than 1, and here the output voltage or second the output voltage must be less than that of primary voltage, and here the primary current I1, the primary current I1 is less than that of secondary current. The primary current I1 is less than that of secondary current. Okay. In next video, I will explain remaining topics of transformers. Okay. All the best.